Welcome to this brief guide on how to translate text using Excel. If you've ever felt lost in a sea of foreign languages within Excel, you're not alone. Whether it's deciphering a client's email, understanding product descriptions from overseas, or analyzing feedback from a global audience, language barriers can seriously slow you down. But what if I told you that you could become an Excel multilingual expert in just a few minutes? In this tutorial, we're diving deep into Excel's powerful language tools, Detect Language and Translate. Imagine you're working on a global project and receive this spreadsheet. This cell here contains some text, but you're not quite sure what language it's in. That's no problem. Let's bring in our language detective, the Detect Language function. Start by typing the equals sign, followed by detect language, and an open parenthesis. This tells Excel that we're about to use this handy function. Next, we need to tell Excel which text to analyze. Simply click on the cell containing the mystery language. Perfect. Now, close the parenthesis and hit enter. And would you look at that? Excel has identified the language as FR, which is the code for French. If we weren't sure before, we know now that this cell contains beautiful French text. Let's try a few more examples to see Detect Language in action. This cell here, identified as DE for German. This one is ES for Spanish. And this one is JA for Japanese. It's like having a pocket translator right inside Excel. All right, we've identified our languages, but what if we want to actually understand them? That's where the translate function steps in, kind of like your own personal interpreter. Once again, begin with the equals sign and then type translate, followed by an open parenthesis. Select the cell containing the text that you want to translate, in this case, our French phrase. Next, we need to specify the source and target languages. We know this is French, so we'll type FR with the quotes, followed by a comma. Then we'll enter EN for English, also in quotes, as that's our desired language. Close that parenthesis, hit enter, and voila! Our French phrase is now magically transformed into English. This next part is a little bit manual, at least for now, but keep watching. But let's go ahead and apply this to the entire column. And just like that, our entire list is now in English. Think of the possibilities. Now you can effortlessly communicate and collaborate with colleagues and customers from around the world. Now let's imagine you have a larger, truly multilingual dataset, like this one. Some cells are in French, others are in German, and who knows what else. We could use Detect Language and Translate separately for each cell, but that would be tedious. Instead, let's combine their powers for a supercharged translation solution. We'll start off with our trusty Translate function, but this time, instead of manually entering in the source language, we'll insert the Detect Language function right inside. This tells Excel to first figure out what language the text is in, and then translate it into English accordingly. And there you have it. With a single formula, we've dynamically translated the text from an unknown language into English. Let's simply copy this formula down and witness the magic unfold. Excel automatically detects the language of each cell and translates it into English, all in one go. This technique is incredibly powerful for large datasets where manually identifying each language would be an absolute nightmare. Think of all the possibilities. You could analyze social media sentiment from around the world, gather insights from multilingual surveys, or even translate entire documents without lifting a finger. With this dynamic duo, the language barrier is no match for you. Remember, don't be afraid to play around with it. These functions can be customized and adapted to fit your specific needs. Try nesting them within other formulas, use them in conjunction with conditional formatting, or even create your own custom translation templates. And if you ever need a refresher, just simply revisit this tutorial or explore the additional resources that I have provided in the video description below. Happy translating, and I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel. And if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.